Check you out. You're here for the iliohypogastric nerve. In recent weeks, we've been looking at the genitofemoral nerve and the ilioinguinal nerve. So now we have to look at the third one of the guys that are around here, the iliohypogastric nerve. That must mean you're some sort of anatomy nerd like me, right? I'd looked at the other two, which are, I mean, this one's clinical as well. The other two were very, very clinically relevant, but this one's like on the periphery, but I felt I had to talk about it. So you obviously feel like you have to listen. The iliohypogastric nerve, we will look to see what it does. We will talk about briefly the hypogastric nerve and the hypogastric plexuses, so you don't mix them up. And then we will look at its origin, so like its root, R-O-O-T, and then follow its root, R-O-U-T-E, around here to its target structures, and then talk about some clinical stuff. Because if you're a surgeon and you're wielding a knife around here, you need to know about this nerve. The iliohypogastric nerve is sensory. This is the pubis bone down here. So the suprapubic skin here, the iliohypogastric nerve is sensory from the skin here. And around here, we have the gluteal region. The iliohypogastric nerve is sensory from some of the skin of the superior gluteal area. Up and around here, and iliohypogastric. Okay, the ilium refers to this bone here, this flank bone. So this is the ilium, ilio, so that's the first part. Hypogastric, okay, gastric you probably associate with stomach, right? Gaster, think of belly, right? Think of that's sort of a stomach, a belly. Hypo is below. So the iliohypogastric nerve is of the ilium, flank bone, and below the belly, hypogastric. It's also going to innervate bits of the muscles of the like anterior abdominal wall. As we follow it around, we'll see what it does as well, all right? Now, iliohypogastric nerve. I say words a lot so that you get used to hearing words, because that's a good way of learning words. Iliohypogastric. I said, don't confuse this with the hypogastric nerve. Now the hypogastric nerve is very, very deep. The iliohypogastric nerve is close to the surface for most of its root, and it's involved in innervating skin and abdominal muscle wall. So it's a somatic nerve. You know, the skin is a somatic thing. It's something you're aware of. These muscles you can control consciously. They're somatic muscles. But down in here, deep inside the pelvis, we have organs. We have viscera, and they are controlled by autonomic nerves. And we have hypogastric plexuses. So plexuses are nerve fibers kind of forming a meshwork, right? So we have a superior hypogastric plexus. That's a collection of autonomic nerves deep in the abdomen. And then that is connected by a hypogastric nerve on either side to inferior hypogastric plexuses on either side, which are also collections of autonomic nerves to do with the viscera. Hypogastric nerve, hypogastric plexuses, deep, autonomic, not today's topic. Iliohypogastric nerve, more superficial, somatic, sensory from patches of skin and motor to muscles of the abdominal wall. All right, so don't mix them up. It's useful, isn't it, to know, to understand what you might mix it up with so that you don't mix it up, so you can understand how not to mix it up. That's just me anyway. I don't like not knowing stuff. The iliohypogastric nerve is a branch of the lumbar plexus. These are the lumbar vertebrae of the low back down here. The spinal nerves that come out from between the lumbar vertebrae will form the lumbar plexus. And the lumbar plexus is then going to form a number of nerves that will run off around the body wall down to the lower limb and do various things, right? So Lumbar vertebrae, I always start down here. There's the sacrum, L5, L4, L3, L2, L1. So that is the L1 spinal nerve root. That is where the iliohypogastric nerve comes from. So that's what we're seeing around here. Now, it's gonna be these guys here. Okay, so can you see how we have the L1 spinal nerve root, and then we have two branches. The ilioinguinal nerve and the iliohypogastric nerve are gonna do similar jobs, and they're gonna go similar places. And here's a funny thing, the size of each nerve is inversely proportional to the other nerve, as in, they're gonna go to similar places and do similar jobs. If one nerve does most of the work, then there's not much left for the other nerves, so the other nerve's quite small, right? To the point that the ilioinguinal nerve might go around and innervate all of the skin around here, and there is no iliohypogastric nerve. It's not necessary. In about 20% of people, there is no iliohypogastric nerve. So there's L1. So look, it's these two here. So, lumbar vertebrae, so we're very deep here. Let's put some muscles on here. Okay, so there's one of the lumbar vertebrae here. These are the blood vessels and muscles of the posterior abdominal wall, and it's worth pointing out the kidneys today. So, the iliohypogastric nerve is going to, I can't take the whole kidney off, but the iliohypogastric nerve is going to come out of the lumbar plexus posterior to this muscle here. This is psoas major. The ilioinguinal and iliohypogastric nerves will separate pretty much at the lateral border of psoas major muscle posterior to the kidney. And then it'll leave psoas major on its lateral border, but posterior to the kidney. This muscle here, this flat muscle, which is actually going to extend all the way up to the vertebrae, this is quadratus lumborum. So the iliohypogastric nerve will at first run between the kidney and the quadratus lumborum muscle laterally and a little bit, you know, like inferiorly. It's going to curve around the body wall is what I'm trying to say. So then we'll first see it appearing from like the lower part of the kidney, from posterior to the kidney. So that's where, if you were to lift up the kidney, you'd find the iliohypogastric nerve, but otherwise you'll see the iliohypogastric nerve here. This nerve is going to curve around the body wall, kind of, it's a bit long here, but it's going to kind of curve around the body wall, kind of like that, sort of, ish. This is a pipe cleaner, you know. Mind you, biology is pretty variable. The muscles here of the lateral and anterior abdominal wall, there are three layers. The deepest layer is transversus abdominis, the middle layer is the internal oblique muscle, and the most superficial layer, the layer closest to the skin, is the external oblique muscle layer. So clearly we are up against transversus abdominis at this point. So as the iliohypogastric nerve curls around the body, it penetrates through the transversus abdominis muscle and then will run between transversus abdominis and internal oblique around the body. And then it splits into two branches, an anterior cutaneous branch and a lateral cutaneous branch. Cutaneous means it's going to go to the skin. But as this nerve is running around the body wall, it will help innervate these muscles of the body wall. So it's usually involved in innervating transversus abdominis and the internal oblique muscles. But because we're segmented animals, there are lots of nerves curving around like this, curving around the body wall, and they're all going to be involved in innervating the muscles of the body wall. But the fact that this nerve has a role is important, and we'll come back later. So the branching of the iliohypogastric nerve occurs in the space or in the layer between the transversus abdominis and internal oblique muscles. Now, okay, so here we can see the bone, you know, the top of the ilium of that iliac bone of the wing of the pelvis there. That's the iliac crest. You can palpate this on yourself, right? That's the So here is the ilium. Here is the iliac crest. Now where the iliac crest ends, this is the anterior superior iliac spine. And from here to the pubis bone down here runs the inguinal ligament. All right, so our nerve is a little bit superior to all of this, but I want you to remember that anatomy. Oh, he's got me here. The lateral cutaneous branch of the iliohypogastric nerve will, superior to the iliac crest, pass through the internal oblique muscle, will pass through the external oblique muscle. Ah, and now look where it is. It is in the superior, lateral, and posterior regions of the part of the gluteal region. So it can then send cutaneous branches to innervate the skin around here. How much skin it innervates, what region of skin it innervates, will vary. Kind of like any dermatome map you look at. Well, there are different dermatome maps. What I'm trying to say is that cutaneous innervation of skin is variable between people and variable between textbooks for that reason. But, you know, the lateral cutaneous branch of the iliohypogastric nerve is going to carry some sensation of the skin from around here normally somewhere. Okay, what about the other branch? Our anterior cutaneous branch of the iliohypogastric nerve is at this point running, it's lying between the transversus abdominis muscle and the internal oblique muscle. And it's gonna curve around the body wall with it because it's in between those two layers, so it's part of the body wall now, like this, a couple of centimeters superior to the inguinal ligament. Now, as it curves around, so there's the end of the iliac crest there, so that's where the anterior superior iliac spine is. It is usually described as piercing through the internal oblique muscle layer, like a couple of centimeters medial to a couple of centimeters away from, it's a little bit superior, a little bit medial to there. That anterior cutaneous branch will pass through the internal oblique muscle and continue its path around here, and then it will pass through the external oblique muscle layer, which is more of an aponeurosis, a flat tendon sheet around here, a couple of centimetres, maybe 2 or 3 centimetres superior to this here. This is the inguinal canal. This is the connecting tube between the abdominopelvic cavity and, in this case, this being a male model, the scrotum. And this opening of the inguinal canal here is the superficial inguinal ring. This is the spermatic cord we see here. So a couple of centimetres, maybe 2.5, 3 centimetres superior to the superficial inguinal ring, the anterior cutaneous branch of the iliohypogastric nerve will penetrate through the external oblique aponeurosis or muscle layer, and now it is close to the skin and it will send off cutaneous branches to carry sensory innervation back from the skin in the suprapubic region. Pubis bone is here, so the skin around here. And that is the path of the nerve. So then, the root of this nerve is clearly important if you're a surgeon and you want to make an incision in the lower abdominal wall. You need to know where this nerve is, expect where to find it, preserve it, don't, you know, so you don't damage it. If you're an anaesthetist, so if a surgeon wanted to do an inguinal hernia repair, oh, by the way, no part of the iliohypogastric nerve goes through the inguinal canal. The iliohypogastric nerve does not go through the inguinal canal. But if you're, if a surgeon is wanting to repair an inguinal hernia, the iliohypogastric nerve is a nerve that the anaesthetist would want to anaesthetize. So if you want to block this, you need to know the root of the nerve. If you were harvesting bone from the iliac crest, which is a good site to do it from because it's very superficial, for, you know, bone graft, autologous bone transfer, bone marrow transplant, bone, you know, all those sorts of things. If you wanted to harvest bone from the iliac crest, you need to be aware that the iliohypogastric nerve is nearby so that you don't damage it. As this muscle is part of, it's within the anterolateral abdominal wall muscles, and it's passing through them, trauma to those muscles can damage this nerve. So think of athletes which tear these muscles, that could also damage the iliohypogastric nerve. So, you know, again, it's one of those little nerves, but it's not really esoteric anatomy. This is useful stuff. The most common way of damaging this nerve is actually surgically, by the way. If this nerve is damaged, well, you have the sorts of sensory problems that you get with a damaged nerve, then a trapped nerve, a crushed nerve. There might be the sensation of pain from the regions of skin that are innervated by that nerve, or pins and needles, or numbness, or burning sensation, that sort of thing. But also, as it has a motor job to part of the muscles of the anterolateral abdominal wall, if that nerve is damaged, the muscles will become weak. If the muscles will become weak, there's an increased chance of the muscle wall weakening, and an increased chance of a hernia in the low anterior abdominal wall. So this is functional anatomy. This is quite an important part of the body. I'm sure there aren't any other little nerves around here I can talk about, right? I'll move on to a different topic next week. But that's the root of the iliohypogastric nerve. Iliohypogastric. So think ilium, the bone of the flank, hypogastric, below the belly. It comes from the L1 spinal nerve root, most commonly, with the ilioinguinal nerve. And those two split posterior from the psoas major muscle and go their own way. The iliohypogastric nerve runs between the kidney and the quadratus lumborum muscle, and then it appears, runs around the anterolateral abdominal wall after piercing through the transversus abdominis muscle to run between transversus abdominis and internal oblique, gives off two branches, the lateral cutaneous branch, which superior to the iliac crest punches through the other layers to get to the skin here. The anterior cutaneous branch runs around, punches through internal oblique here, external oblique here, carries sensory innervation back from the skin of the suprapubic region, and innervates the muscles while it's going past, because that's a helpful thing to do, isn't it? All right, iliohypogastric nerve anatomy, done. See you next week.